you can see in the template gallery, there is a blank quiz form. However, we will try to start from a blank form in order for you to know the basics. Suppose you are an English teacher and you want to have a quiz about famous opening lines in books. But first, we need to set that form into a quiz form. Enable the Make This a Quiz and then save. Now, we have to name your form. This part is the first section of your quiz. We have to describe your section 1 to expound its purpose. Create the first question. With this part, we need to require them to input their names. Remember to enable this part so that they will be required to fill out this question. Now create your second question, be it their section or gender, so that they need to fill out in order for you to easily identify them. You can choose on how they will answer this question, but we will choose the short answer option. What if you accidentally added a question to section 1? We click this bin button to delete this. Now, we will click this button to add another section. Create your quiz section. This section could be separated in order for your Google form to be easier to navigate. Add your section title and the description. For this video tutorial, we'll be getting our sample questions from pubquizquestionshq.com. For the first question, it would be who is the author of the book To Kill a Mockingbird? Add choices. Notice that every word we type, Google Form automatically adds another field. If you want to indicate the points, just click this answer key button, click the correct answer, and input the point this question has. Click done. For this section, I will show you how you can import questions from other existing forms. I made another form to show you how you can transfer questions from another form. Select all and then import the four questions. Notice that there is now a point system that is indicated. The current total point is 22. Every question has its own points. Even the correct answers are imported, and it is also indicated. Suppose you want to add another question, like a bonus question. Suppose you want to add a bonus question that involves images. Click this image button and upload. From your hard drive, you can get an image that will be used in the form. Suppose that this bonus question will ask the students to identify the book cover. Type the correct answers. The answer to this question is Catcher in the Rye. But you can also add the Catcher in the Rye since some students would include the article the. Then mark all other answers incorrect. And indicate also the point that this question or this bonus question possesses. Click done. Then, what if you want to include a video? For example, a video is needed for your next lesson. Just click that button, and if your video can be found in YouTube, this would be easy. I search for XRBA and click one of his videos. Indicate the instruction for this section. if you want to design your form. Click the palette button and then insert the image for header. Choose your theme color and then the background color. Also choose the font. Easy, right? Now your form has design. To finish this whole process, you can send it via email or you can copy the link. Notice that there is no save button. We can see that this part here says that all changes saved in Drive. So rest assured that if you accidentally click the exit button, you can just go back to this form in your Google Drive. To see the responses, we can click the spreadsheet button. If there is a response that was recorded, it will show up to this spreadsheet. If you want to move the column with the score, we can easily move it and move it back. You can also click the accepting responses if you want to include a deadline. That's it for today. I'm Camela from QUIDIP, STEM Uno represents.